Hello, my name is John, and this is the Mask Face Journal, and this is what I read this week. Let's begin with Suicide Squad number 2, written by Rob Williams and art by Jim Lee and Ivan Reis. In part 2. I'm beginning to think that this book might not be for me. It started off better than the last issue, but then took a turn. There's some decent dialogue, and the art is, well, Jim Lee, but nothing in the story really grabbed me. You can't say that this book doesn't have stakes, and it doesn't have twists, but it doesn't really work for me. The backup story that features Captain Boomerang is serviceable, but it feels pretty typical. Superwoman number 2, written and drawn by Phil Jimenez. You can't complain that this book has slow pacing, that's for sure. There's a lot going on here, so much in fact that it's difficult to keep track of everything that happens. Last issue I felt was a bait and switch, and while this issue is not quite as tumultuous, I feel that it is yet to establish a firm footing. There are some character relationships that I'm not sure has been established anywhere before, and it's presented kinda strange if they haven't. Other characters are also in different places from when we've seen them last, without any explanation as to why. Maggie Sawyer, for example, is back in Metropolis, and the last page reveal suffers similar issues. That is less of a problem right now, as that is likely to be explored. The Flash number 6, written by Joshua Williamson and art by Carmine Giannomenico. If you've been reading this book so far, this issue gives us perhaps the least surprising twist since the reveal of who Benedict Cumberbatch was playing in Star Trek Into Darkness. There's also some melodrama worthy of the CW, in this instance a character not seeing the big picture and runs away in anger. I'm not going to hold that against it though, as it brings up some very interesting things, like for example, Barry seems to be able to remember Crisis on Infinite Earths. Overall, I enjoyed this issue, and I think it's about time that the villain Godspeed is being used. And boy is he used. Wonder Woman number 6, written by Greg Rucka and art by Nicholas Scott. This is the origin part of the alternating stories. Short review incoming. I love this. I love everything about this. The dialogue is good, the art is fantastic, and the characters are all believable. This also connects with the other stories set in the present, in that it's now beginning to make a lot of sense for Wonder Woman to seek out Cheetah for help. Again, can't stress this enough, I love this. Batgirl on the Birds of Prey number 2, written by Julia and Shauna Benson and art by Claire Rowe and Roj Antonio. This is alright. Nothing breathtaking, but also nothing really to complain about. There's a few nitpicks here and there. Barbara has a giant chip on her shoulder towards the men in her life, and I'm not sure that's called for. Also, she's sitting right next to her father in a car, yet he can't recognize her as his daughter. I know, suspension of disbelief, but still. Can we do what we did back in the 70s and 80s, where Commissioner Gordon was fully aware that his daughter was Batgirl? It's been over 30 years since that was tried before, just saying. Detective Comics, number 940, written by James Tynion IV and art by Eddie Barrows. This is the end of the Rise of the Batman story, and what an ending it is. A lot of what has been building comes to a conclusion here, and it also sets up a few new threads and connects the story with the larger universe and Rebirth as a whole. There are, however, a few questions that really need answers but doesn't get them. In previous episodes I mentioned that the story hints that Batman is wrong in his assertions about the undercover terrorist cells, and the ending doesn't deal with that. There's a really emotional scene here between Batman and Spoiler of all people that makes complete sense in context. What troubles me is that there is an upcoming multi-book crossover. I really hate that. It makes rereading and catching up nearly impossible. All-Star Batman number 2, written by Scott Snyder and art by John Romita Jr. Snyder is still trying to write the most important Batman story ever. That seems to be his approach to all of his Batman stories, and sometimes it works, other times not so much. So far, this definitely works. It's suspenseful and action-packed. It keeps giving us flashes into the future that implies that Bruce Wayne's secret identity has been exposed to the world, and that the GCPD is at Wayne Manor to arrest him. The way it's framed, however, makes it very possible to be complete misdirection, and it's hard not to see the way out instead of just being immersed in the narrative. Snyder also has a take on Two-Face I'm not sure has ever been done before. If I'm interpreting things right, he seems to imply that Two-Face exists in a state of either fully Harvey Dent or fully Two-Face, and whenever he pulls a caper that lands him in Arkham, it's because Two-Face feels that Harvey's beginning to take over and deliberately gets himself caught, so that Harvey is the one behind bars. I'm not sure how the coin flipping plays into that though. Action Comics number 963, written by Dan Jurgis and art by Patrick Surcher. This issue kicks off a new story arc, and with this new story comes a switch in perspective. Instead of following Superman, we're following Clark Kent. The new Clark Kent, that is. The one who has no superpowers, and claims to have never been Superman. That is, for all we know, true, as the previous New 52 Superman withered away into dust. This focuses on the public's unwillingness to buy the story that he was never Superman, which makes sense, after all he was publicly outed. The other side of the story is Clark doing some investigative journalism. We still don't learn anything new this issue. It exists as a promise to deal with the mysteries presented in Rebirth, but most likely due to its bi-weekly publishing schedule extends these reveals as far as possible. This is very likely to read better in trades than in singles. So that was what I read this week. Did you enjoy this video? Like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video. Did you not like it or disagree with me? Let me know in the comments. That was it for this week.